ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. فقال سبحانه وتعالى: أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها. صدق الله العلي العظيم. إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. جزا الله عنا سيدنا مولانا محمدا صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم ما هو أهله. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. اللهم يا كريم أكرمنا بنور الفهم وأخرجنا من ظلمات الوهم، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. تقریر شروع کرنے سے پہلے میں تمام احباب سے گزارش کرتا ہوں، جنہیں کوئی تکلیف نہ ہو، کہ وہ ابھی سے ہی اپنی صفحے مکمل فرما دیں تاکہ بعد میں آنے والوں کے لیے پریشانی کا باعث نہ بنے. آپ آگے تشریف لے، اللہ تعالیٰ آپ سب کو جزائے خیر عطا فرمائے. درود شریف، اللہم صلی علی سیدنا و مولانا محمد معد الجود والکرم وآلہ وصحبہ وبارک وسلم. مولای صلی وسلم دائما ابدا علی حبیبک خیر الخلق کلہم. مختصر انشاءاللہ آپ کے سامنے جمعۃ الوداع شریف میں اس مبارک و مسعود مہینہ جو ہم سے ابھی الوداع ہونے والا ہے، اس کے متعلق جو کچھ خاص سبق ہمیں ملتا ہے اور جس چیز سے ہمیں خاص تعلق رکھنا چاہیے، وہ جو سبق ہمیں دینے کے لیے یہ مہمان آیا، اس کے متعلق انشاءاللہ آپ کے سامنے چند ساتھیں گفتگو جاری رہے گی. اس کے بعد انشاءاللہ آپ الوداع اشعار بھی سماعت کریں گے، اور اس طرح ہم اپنا آخری جمعہ ادا کریں گے. اللہ تعالی ہم سب کو یہ مہمان بار بار عطا فرمائے. اگلے سال بھی ہمیں اللہ تعالی صحت عافیت برکت کے ساتھ، اور جس طریقے سے اللہ تعالی نے اس مقدس مہینے کو بطور مہمان ہم تک پہنچائے، اس کے حق ادا کرتے ہوئے ہمیں اس استقبال کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے. اللہ رب العزت قرآن عظیم میں ارشاد فرماتا ہے: شہر رمضان الذی انزل فیہ القرآن، کہ جب اللہ تعالیٰ نے رمضان شریف کے مبارک مہینے کا تعارف پیش فرمایا تو اس میں صرف یہ نہیں بتایا کہ اس میں آپ روزے رکھتے ہیں، اس میں آپ قیام اللیل کرتے ہیں، بلکہ جب رمضان شریف کے مبارک و مسعود مہینے کا تعارف کرنے کی بات آئی تو اللہ تعالی ارشاد فرماتا ہے: شہر رمضان الذی انزل فیہ القرآن. رمضان شریف کا مہینہ کیا ہے؟ رمضان شریف کا مہینہ وہ مہینہ ہے جس میں اللہ رب العزت نے قرآن پاک نازل فرمایا. اللہ ڈیفائنز دا بلیسڈ منتھ آف رمضان، a few moments of which we have with us, after which we will all bid farewell to this blessed month with tears in our eyes, in anticipation and hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshallah next year, with the condition that we still are alive and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has still given us the amana of our life, that we welcome this blessed month again next year inshallah with great fervor and passion and blessings, and fulfilling its rights, its due rights, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the sacred traditions. Ameen ya rab. When Allah defines this blessed month of Ramadan, he says this is the blessed month of Ramadan in which Allah revealed the Quran. Even when you say it, Ramadan, Quran, very similar in pronunciation, to make you understand the deep connection that Quran has with Ramadan, and Ramadan which has with the Quran. Ramadan and Quran go hand in hand. What is this Quran? What are the blessings of this Quran? What is the magnitude of knowledge which this noble Quran possesses? Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in a verse which you had already listened to if you were reciting or listening to Surah Al-Kahf, which you should all recite, something, a practice that you should all continue
After the blessed month of Ramadan, he should recite Surah Al-Kahf every Friday. Anyone who recites Surah Al-Kahf on a Friday of the night preceding it, which is Friday night. Yani Thursday night, because Islamically the night starts after Maghrib. The day starts after Maghrib, the night preceding the Jumu'ah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will expiate all of his sins from this Jumu'ah to the previous Jumu'ah. In one narration it says, from this Jumu'ah until the next Jumu'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all of your minor sins. In one narration it says, anyone who punctually recites Surah Al-Kahf with diligence, with deliberation, with sincerity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will create a nur that will illuminate everything between him and Al-Baytullah Al-Atiq, the ancient house of Allah, the Ka'batullah Al-Haram. In that surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّي لَنَفِذَ الْبَحْرُ قَبْلَ أَن تَنْفَذَ كَلِمَاتُ رَبِّي وَلَوْ جِئْنَا بِمِثْلِهِ مَدَدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the Qur'an, the knowledge of the Qur'an, the knowledge which the Qur'an contains. This is knowledge, not just information that we have on the internet. Pure knowledge. Knowledge directly from Allah. Allah says, O beloved, say to the people that if we were to bring oceans, rather, seven oceans in one other verse, Sab'ati Abuhur, in order for the oceans to be turned into ink, to inscribe the words of Allah, to expound on the words of Allah, مَا نَفِذَتْ كَلِمَاتُ اللَّهِ, the oceans would exhaust themselves, the trees that would be the pens, they would dry up, but at the end the kalimat of Allah would never exhaust. They are limitless. And I have before me, Subhanallah. Say Subhanallah.
Subhanallah.
An amazing book, which Al-Azhar rahmatullahi wrote as a commentary of his masterpiece, which he wrote in 8 hours in Makkatul Mukarramah, without any books, without any resources, through divine esoteric knowledge which was inspired to him, Ad-Dawlatul Makkiyah bil Madatil Ghaybiyah. He wrote a hashiya, which is not a hashiya, it is a book in itself, expands to more than 300 pages, which he wrote, Imba'ul Hayy Anna Kalamahul Masoon Tibyanul Likulli Shay. What is he mentioning that? آپ فرماتے ہیں رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ, عثماوی کی شرح صلات سیدی احمد کبیر رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ میں ہے کہ ہمارے سردار شیخ عمر محدار بیان فرماتے ہیں کہ اگر میں چاہوں کہ تمہیں زبانی بتلا کر لکھا دوں کچھ تفسیر اس آیت کے بارے میں, کون سی آیت, ما ننسخ من آیت او ننسیہا نأتی بخیر منہا او مثلیہا, تو 100,000 اونٹ لد جائے.
Allah,
what does he say? If I was to write a commentary of the verse on abrogation, ما ننسخ من آیت ننسیہا نأتی بخیر منہا او مثلیہا, this wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I would need 100,000 camels to carry the weight of the books in which I would write the commentary of this single verse of the Quran. This is the Quran. Everything is in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala identifies every single problem that you shall face, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the solution to every single problem in the Quran. What does he then say? Sheikh Ali Al-Khawas rahimahullah bayan farmate hain, Allah ta'ala ne mujhe muttala farmaya surah Fatiha ke maani par, to mujhe unmein se 140,990 ilm munkashif hue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the veils to the knowledge of the Quran, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which not in the Quran, just in the Quran, in Surah Al-Fatiha, in Ummul Kitab, in Fatihatul Kitab, and he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired to me 140,990 sciences of knowledge just in Surah Al-Fatiha. Not only this, what does he then further say? Imam Sha'arani rahmatullah alayhi says in Mizan al-Shari'ah al-Kubra, a very famous book of his, that my brother Sheikh Akhi Hafdhuluddin bayan farmaya, कि उन्होंने सूरह फातिहा में से 247,999 इल्म इस्तिखराज किए निकाले. अल्लाह, हम भी सूरह फातिहा पढ़ हम हर रोज पढ़ते हैं, लेकिन हमारा पढ़ना और औलिया किराम का पढ़ना जमीन आसमान का फर्क रखता है. वो जब पढ़ते हैं उनके दिलों से पर्दे उठ जाते हैं और हमारे दिलों के ऊपर कसीफ गुनाहों के पर्दे लगे हुए हैं. इसलिए कुरान शरीफ का इल्म का महक हमारे अंदर जज्ब नहीं होता है. जिस दिन हम इन पर्दों को हटाएंगे, तोबा के जरिए, इस्तिग़फ़ार के जरिए, तज़किए के जरिए, शहवात को दूर करते हुए और अल्लाह ताला की इतिबा करते हुए, तो इंशाअल्लाह तमाम उलूम आपके अंदर भी आ जाएंगे. What does he say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sheikh Imam Sha'arani rahmatullah mentions, Allah inspired in my brother Sheikh Afdaluddin how many sciences of knowledge? 247,999 sciences of knowledge just from Suratul Fatiha. This is just an excerpt I just mentioned to you here from this kitab. Nonetheless, what is the Quran? Durud shukr Allah salli ala sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad ma'adin judi wal karami wali wa barik wa salim. What is the power of the Quran? What is the effect of the Quran? Allahu Akbar. Sayyidina Jubair ibn Mut'im radiyallahu ta'ala anhu bayan farmate hain ke abhi main musharraf ba Islam nahi hua tha, abhi maine Islam qabul nahi kiya tha. Nabi Kareem sallallahu ta'ala alaihi wasallam namaz maghrib mein surah Tur tilawat farmate the, farma rahe the. Jab aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam is ayat par aap pahunche, aapne uski tilawat farmayi, am khuliqu min ghayri shay'in am humul khaliqun, ya ek riwayat ke mutabik jab aapne is ayat ki tilawat farmayi, in azab rabbika lawaqi' ma lahu min dafi'. Hazrat Jubair ibn Mut'im radhiyallahu ta'ala bayan farmate hain jab ye aakhri ayat khas taur par aap tilawat farma rahe the, to maine aisa mehsoos kiya ki abhi mere upar azab ilahi aane wala hai. Ghair muslim the, अभी वो आपने इस्लाम कबूल नहीं किया था, उसका असर ये हुआ कि मैं फौरन नबी करीम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की बारगाह में गया जब आप नमाज से फारिग हुए और मैंने आपके दस्ते हक परस पर इस्लाम कबूल किया और आपका कलमा पढ़ा. दिस इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ द कुरान. सैयदना जुबैर इब्न मुतइम रदियल्लाहु तआला अनहु, ए नॉन मुस्लिम, ही हैड नॉट येट एम्ब्रेस्ड इस्लाम, एंड ही मेंशंस द स्टोरी बिहाइंड हिज कन्वर्जन दैट द मैसेंजर सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम was performing the Salatul Maghrib and he was reciting the Quran aloud, and specifically in that namaz he was reciting Surah At-Tur. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam reached this verse, inna azaba rabbika lawaqi' ma lahu min dafi', if only we were to understand the translation, at least the translation of the meaning of the verses of the Quran, if only something that you can take back with you throughout the 11 months. Yeah, put an effort, exert effort, inshallah, to understand the meanings of the Quran. Understand the meaning of the message which Allah has sent to you. This is a divine code, a letter, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has addressed you with. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent it to you, but we don't understand it. Has Jubair ibn Mut'im radiallahu ta'ala, one of the most eloquent people of Arabia, he says, when I heard this verse of the Quran that the azab, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is imminent, there is no one who can avert the punishment of Allah. Inna azab rabbika lawaqi' ma lahu min dafi'. I began to shiver, I began to tremble. Non-Muslim. And it seemed as though the azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was right above my head. It was about to fall upon me. It was about to crush me. It was about to annihilate me. When I approached the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after he had finished his prayer and I embraced Islam at his hands just by listening to one verse of the Quran. In the valley of Nakhla, when the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after what happened in Tabuk, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam proceeded towards the valley of Nakhla, Wadi Nakhla, and he was reciting the Quran. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reciting the Quran in the prayer, and there was an influx of jinn, of the jinn fraternity who came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one after the other they embraced Islam because of hearing the verses of the Quran. This is the power of the Quran. Yes, it inspires people. I told you this incident before, I'm going to repeat it again. The great famous reciter of the Quran, Subhanallah. Whose recitation penetrates through your hearts. Even now, he's not with us. Rahimahullah, Shaykh Qari Abdul Basit Abdul Samad, Rahimahullah. He was taken to the then USSR, Russia, by the then president of Egypt, Jamal Abdul Nasser. He took him in a conference with non-Muslims, and before the conference commenced, Jamal Abdul Nasser had already fixed that Shaykh Abdul Basit would recite a few verses of the Quran. So he began to recite verses of Surah Al-Rahman. He began to recite verses of Surah. Shaykh Abdul Basit rahimahullah, he mentions that before I even went onto the mic, I prayed to Allah, "Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am before a group of non-Muslims. The majority of them are non-Muslims. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, grant such effect in my recitation that it makes a revolution in their hearts. That it creates a change in their heart." Do you know what happened after he completed the recitation of the Quran? After the conference finished, 6 people came and they embraced Islam at the hands of Shaykh Abdul Basit Abdul Samad, rahimahullah. They said, "This cannot be the words of any human being. These are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the divine words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the message that we receive, that we gain from the blessed month of Ramadan. Connect yourself with the Quran." Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, people were finishing 1 juz, 2 juz, 3 juz of the Quran every single daily. They had this routine, they were very, very punctual in reciting the Quran. Yes, after Ramadan you will have responsibilities, you will go to work and so forth. But Islam doesn't require to recite 3 juz of the Quran every single day. What Islam says, أَحَبُّ الْأَعَمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلْ. The best of all routes that you can take, routes that you can follow, the best routine that you can adopt is things which are small in quantity, but they are done regularly. ये नहीं कहते हैं, इस्लाम ये नहीं कहता है कि आप हर रोज जो है एक सिपारा पढ़ो, एक पारा पढ़ो कुरान शरीफ का, दो पारे पढ़ो, तीन पारे पढ़ो. इस्लाम ये कहता है थोड़ा थोड़ा अमल करो, लेकिन मुदावमत के साथ, हमेशगी के साथ इस अमल को इख्तियार करो, क्योंकि यही सबसे ज्यादा पसंदीदा अमल है अल्लाह के नज़दीक और उसके प्यारे रसूल के नज़दीक. इवन इफ इट्स 1 पेज ऑफ द कुरान बिफोर यू गो टू वर्क, रिसाइटेड बाय अल्लाह, यू विल सी द बरकत. You will gradually increase from 1 page to 2 pages to 3 pages to 4 pages. And alhamdulillah, subhanallah, you will never become exhausted. You will increase this daily routine. You will find the spiritual effect of the Quran in your daily lives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will alleviate your problems. Allah subhanahu will grant you shifa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inshallah accept all of your permissible needs through the barak of the Quran. Just to finish off inshallah, a few ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam in relation to the virtue of reciting the Quran. Subhanallah. Duru shibri Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad ma'adini judi wal karami wa alayhi wa barik wa salim. I have this beautiful book before me. Subhanallah. Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah wrote this book. He actually mentioned it in Muqaddima, that when I was in studying in Damascus, alhamdulillah, I saw people greatly inclined towards the Quran, studying it, learning sciences, teaching to other people. So I decided to write a book in relation to the adab, the etiquette of reciting the Quran. Because if you don't have the etiquette of reciting the Quran, you will not be able to maximize the potential you can gain from the Quran. If you want to gain the maximum from the Quran, have adab. Listen to the adab, adhere to these etiquettes of the Quran. You can't read the Quran like you read a Shakespearean book or a novel. Okay, the Quran has strict adab, which even Allah mentions in the Quran. لا يمسوا إلا المطهرون. وإذا قرأت القرآن فاستعذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Allah has laid down strict principles. This is not like an ordinary book. These are the direct words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The inimitable Quran are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Sahaba, when they used to look at the Mus'haf, they used to pick up the Mus'haf, they used to kiss it. And they were overwhelmed with such ecstatic love and passion with the Quran. They used to kiss it and says, هَذَا كَلَامُ رَبِّي, هَذَا كَلَامُ رَبِّي. These are the words of my Lord, these are the words of my Lord. This is the Quran. Don't just look at the cover. These are the words of the Quran. In that kitab, Imam An-Nawawi then wrote this kitab, subhanAllah. And an amazing book, mashallah. In the Muqaddimah, he mentions the fadail of studying the Quran, reciting the Quran, teaching the Quran. He mentions one hadith, rawahu al-imam Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ismail ibn Abi Ibrahim al-Bukhari rahimahullah fi sahihihi. عن عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the best amongst you is the one who learns the Quran and then teaches the Quran. Who's saying this? Not we, not the public giving you a prominent status. The greatest of the entire creation, the best of the creation of Allah, is saying the best amongst people are those who learn the Quran, who recite the Quran, deeply contemplate on their meanings, try and derive sciences and knowledge from the Quran, and then do not restrict it to themselves, but then they impart their knowledge to other people. Whatever knowledge you have, pass it on to other people. Okay, this is why Imam Sufyan al-Thawri says here, سَأَلْتُ سُفْيَانَ الثَّوْرِ يَعْنِي رَجُلِ يَغْزُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ أَوْ يَقْرُ الْقُرْآنَ. Imam Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah was asked, who is better? The one who goes in the battlefield for jihad fi sabilillah, slaying the enemy and at the end drinking from the ode of martyrdom, is he better or the one who recites the Quran? He says, in my sight, the one who sits and recites the Quran, deduces the knowledge of the Quran, then teaches it to other people is better than mujahid fi sabilillah. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, the best person from amongst all of you is the one who learns the Quran and then teaches it to other people. In one hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الذي يقرأ القرآن وهو ماهر به مع السفرة الكرام البررة. الله أكبر. The one who recites the Quran with eloquence, with articulation, with تجويد. Okay? يعني with تجويد, making sure that he distinguishes each letter with the proper مخرج, the place from each letter, which from each letter is pronounced. ماهر به. He will be resurrected amongst as-safaratil kiramil barara, the angels of the loftiest riyam who write on the lawh mahfuz. He'll be with them. But then the Prophet ﷺ said, وَالَّذِي يَقْرَى الْقُرْآنَ وَهُوَ يَتَتَعْتَعْ يَتَتَعْتَعْ. As for those who recite the Quran, and as well as trying to learn rules of tajweed, putting as much effort in, they still struggle, they stammer, they stop. They cannot recite it as fluently. The Prophet ﷺ said, لَهُ أَجْرَان. They will have two rewards. The first, because of reciting the Quran. The second, even though they are struggling, they are still continuing to recite the Quran, Allah will give them the reward of perseverance as well. SubhanAllah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam said, in one hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. Recite the Quran. Quran Sharif ki tilawat ko karte raho. Quran Sharif padhte raho. Kyunki qiyamat ke roz Allah Ta'ala Quran Sharif ko shafaat karne wala laega, aur Quran Sharif shafaat Allah Ta'ala ke liye qabool ki jayegi. Recite, continuously recite the Quran, because this very Quran that you're reciting will bear witness for you, and Allah will accept the intercession of the Quran, and through the intercession of the Quran, Allah will admit you into Jannah, inshallah, in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا حسد إلا في اثنتين رجل آتاه الله القرآن فهو يقوم به آناء الليل وآناء النهار ورجل آتاه الله مالا فهو ينفقه آناء الليل وآناء النهار. This is حسد. حسد used here is in the meaning of غبطة. غبطة means to have praiseworthy jealousy. Not jealousy in a bad way, in a negative way. There are two types of jealousy. Jealousy which is obviously blameworthy. Another person's got wealth, another person's been conferred with a blessing, and you say, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, eradicate this blessing from me. Take it away from me. I cannot bear to see him with that blessing. The other type of jealousy is that when you see someone who is engaged in teaching knowledge, who is engaged in learning the sciences of knowledge, who is engaged in reciting the Quran, you look at him, you see a rich person, affluent person who gives in the way of Allah, you look at such people and say, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if only I had enough wealth like him, I would have also spent it like he does. If only I was given knowledge of the Quran, I would have recited like he does. If only I had been given granted time, I would have learned the knowledge like he does and then would have taught it to other people. This is known as ghibta. The Prophet said, there is no praiseworthy jealousy, only in two types of people. Rajulun atahu Allahul Quran, in one person who was granted knowledge of the Quran, who was reciting it during the day, reciting it during the night, he was 24 hours connected with the Quran, have jealousy with him. Have praiseworthy jealousy. Ask Allah, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just as you have granted tawfiq to him to recite the Quran, grant me also that tawfiq to recite the Quran, to be with the Quran in this dunya, to be with the Quran in the grave, to be with the Quran on the plane of hashr, on the plane of gathering, to be with the Quran on the sirat, to be with the Quran, enter with the Quran in Jannatul Firdaus, inshaAllah. And then the Prophet said, رَجُلٍ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا. In one narration it says, فَسَلَّطَهُ عَلَى هَلَكَتِي فِي الْحَقِّ. So he spends it in order to propagate the truth, in order to, subhanAllah, in order to propagate the deen of Islam. He spends it in charity for the sake of Allah, out of sincerity. Have hasad with him, praiseworthy hasad with him. And ask, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, grant me such wealth so I can also spend in your way. Final hadith, inshallah. Just to make you understand the virtues and the merits of the Quran al-Kareem. Subhanallah. وعن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله تعالى فله به حسنة. Whoever recites one letter, let me emphasize this. Okay, we are going here then everywhere to gain good deeds. The Quran. Go to the Quran. One letter of the Quran that you recite, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a good deed. But then the Prophet ﷺ said, وَالْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا. One good deed is multiplied 10 times. And if you do it in the month of Ramadan, it is multiplied even greater and greater. وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah multiplies it even further and further and further beyond your imagination. Because of one letter of the Quran. Then the Prophet ﷺ clarified this. لَا أَقُولْ أَلِفْ لَامْ مِيمْ حَرْفٌ ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. I'm not saying ألف لام ميم حروف مقطعات, which consists of three letters. I'm not saying all of these, a combination of these three letters is one letter. ألف is a letter, لام is a letter, ميم is a letter. Anyone who recites ألف لام ميم, he will be granted 30 rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mulla Ali Qari rahimahullah says, other ulama have interpreted this hadith to be alif lam mim. When you recite alif, how many letters do you pronounce? Alif lam wafa. When you say lam, how many letters do you pronounce? Lam wal alif wal mim. When you say mim, how many letters do you pronounce? Mim wa ya wa mim. So anyone who recites alif lam mim, he will be granted 90 rewards. Alif lam mim, 90 rewards. This is the Quran. So connect yourself with the Quran, okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open your hearts towards the unseen realm through the Quran. The Quran will be an intercessor for you. The Quran is shifa. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنْ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Imam Abdul Wahhab Sha'ni rahmatullah mentions in Lataiful Minan, from the blessings which Allah has conferred upon me is that I have never gone to a doctor, all the shifa that I wanted, I got from the Quran. I recited the Quran, Allah gave me shifa through the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us through the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the intercession of the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the intercession of the Quran on our behalf. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.